Almost every day, Qassam rockets hit Sderot, and almost every day, nothing is said abroad about the rocket-weary town. Who are these people who live under constant threat of rocket fire? How do they manage? What is their story? Those are the questions a delegation from the American Jewish Committee wanted to learn more about. How a town can survive after being on the front line for 7 years.
Great admiration for the courage and commitment of the people of Sderot. They live lives of enormous stress that I don't think we fully appreciated until we actually got here.
On the outside, it's easy to dismiss Sderot. Media coverage tends to focus on the Israeli operations in Gaza to stop rocket fire. The number of Hamas men killed as they fire rockets into Israel overshadow the injuries and fear the people of Sderot experience, the constant stress that can drive people to the edge. The AGC worked to overcome the international community's ignoring of the situation in Sderot. By coming to Israel and seeing the effects of terror firsthand, stories that are not told can have a new voice and understanding abroad. The message of the AGC to Israelis living on the front line is clear.
The problem, of course, and you know this better than I do, is that more attention has been focusing on Gaza than it has been on Sderot. More attention has been faced, and perhaps that's not a bad idea if the attention causes a cessation of the rockets. But so far, the attention on Gaza has not caused a cessation of the rockets, and it has left the people of Sderot somewhat in the background. And it's very difficult to turn that around, except by visits by people like ourselves from the United States, who will, in the Jewish community of the United States, the American Jewish Committee is certainly committed to conveying what I've just said to you to a great many people in the United States.
Now that the AJC is on their way back home, the people of Sderot hope their message works.